Welcome to Dance Mogul Magazine. Thank you for taking the time to sit down with us. We really appreciate you. Can you please introduce yourself to our audience?
Yeah, sure. I am Alex Clayton. I'm originally from Louisville, Kentucky, and I've lived in New York now for about 4 years.
Okay, so what was it like growing up in Kentucky and trying to pursue dance?
Well, I hadn't decided that I was going to dance professionally until my senior year of high school. I was actually a visual artist and was going to go into architecture, and then I saw the Ailey Company perform in Louisville and stopped everything and decided that I wanted to pursue dance. So I had to kind of like double major my senior year of high school and did dance there, and then eventually graduated and then went to a 3-year college BFA program in Missouri and then moved to New York.
Okay. Transitioning to New York, what was that process like for you, being in the Big Apple and pursuing dance, trying to get gigs and, you know, the grind?
Yeah. Well, it's been intense, it's been great, but very hard. So often there are so many dancers and so few positions open that, you know, ultimately, you know, you always have to have multiple jobs. So it was retail for a little while, and now I've switched into like babysitting also simultaneously. But it's always like juggling 3 or 4 jobs at the same time, and then also trying to make time to do dance or go to auditions or make room for rehearsals. So,
gotcha. So, leading up to now with Christopher, take us behind the scenes of that, preparing for that, and getting ready to, you know, give the audience a great experience.
Yeah, totally. So we're performing Christopher, which is like an adaptation of Cinderella, of Snow White, and the ideas of beauty. And so the rehearsal process was 4-hour chunks of a lot of creation and going through and changing things and finding formations and digging deeper into like what we're trying to convey, what the meaning is. Lots of sore nights and Epsom salt baths, and like stretching and taking class the next day to making sure that you stay in shape for this rehearsal process, making sure you're staying sharp and quick and not injuring yourself. Just because, you know, like particularly Jair is you know, he's not just like throwing movement out. It's definitely a collaborative dance experience. So you being present in the space and being able to contribute to the experience is ultimately what is the product that we are putting on now. So being present and in the moment and adding and not holding yourself back is what this process has been.
Okay. How do you guys find the balance between the art and what's actually going on in society today? Like, how are you guys mixing that with the performance and, you know, making things different? You know, every year, every season, you know, companies put out pieces and different things like that. What is setting you guys apart? Like, how are you finding that balance to set yourself apart but still be relevant in today's society with dance?
Of course. I think one thing is taking either subject matter or something that is easily relatable. Like, you know, most people are very familiar with Snow White and the concept that there is a person who is beautiful, and kind of like dealing with that, and then taking that and kind of flipping it to, you know, like what are our ideals of beauty? Why is she beautiful? Why is he beautiful? And then also we are an all-male cast, so that's also something that is like interesting and different, particularly with the story, which is like, you know, like female-based and now it's male-based and all the characters are male. What does that mean? Then like adding on layers to that, like social climate, you know, the social climate of, you know, like, you know, like this is sexual, this is homosexual, or whatever the case is, LGBTQ studies and correlations with that, like how do we as a subculture interact with that with ourselves? How do people perceive us as that? How do we interact with their perceptions, you know, like there are parts where there are magazines and we're looking at it and it's like, are we a reflection of this magazine or is a magazine a reflection of what it is that we're doing? So yeah, it's just very much paralleling what is kind of happening now, and then sort of the side effects of that, whether it's positive or negative.
Okay, well, thank you for your time. I really appreciate it. That was a great answer. Thank
cool.
you. Appreciate it.
Awesome.